going to be in Tallahassee, and they are going to realign the congressional districts, the state house districts, and the state senate districts in accordance with the new census. This is something that they have to do every decade in order to make sure that the one rule they have to follow in creating legislative districts is followed. And that one rule is very simple. All the districts for like office have to have approximately the same number of people in them. Now, since they have no other rules, then what do they do when they go ahead and decide to try to make the districts? Well, they're politicians. And the first rule of any politician is that you not only want to be elected, but you want to keep getting elected, and you want your party to keep control of the seat that you're in. So when you start drawing the district boundaries, you engage in an old American political sport, which is known as gerrymandering. Okay? That comes from Elbridge Gerry back in the 1790s in Massachusetts, and we've been doing it happily ever since. And what that boils down to is this. What you do is, and it works especially well now with computers, what you do is you use computers to analyze the voters, okay? And you start packing your opposition party with huge majorities into a very small number of districts. And then you create your own stronghold districts with safe but smaller minorities, and you basically ensure that your party is going to control the election. That's why we have about two-thirds of the state house and the state senate controlled by the Republican Party. But in terms of actual registration, Republicans are only 36% of registered voters. Democrats are 42% of registered voters, and independents are about 22% of registered voters. So this shows that gerrymandering tends to work. The other evidence that it works is that in many races, as many as 40 to 60 a year, okay, for the state house and the state senate, the people run without opposition. And they run without opposition because their districts are so safe that the other party, recognizing that there's no future spending your money there trying to throw somebody out, unless somebody commits an unspeakable act on the courthouse with all the TV cameras there, and that may not even work as we see in the presidential election. So here's the deal. In the areas where they have had competition, over the last three election cycles, 420 separate contests for the state house and the state senate, exactly three incumbents have lost. Now, that's the real problem, folks, because whether you're a Republican or a Democrat doesn't make any difference. It's unhealthy to have a system that is so safe, because when politicians are safe, and they are not afraid that they might not be reelected, okay? That they might actually have to run for office and serve the interests of the voters. Then they can basically start serving themselves, and they can start serving special interests. And all I have to do is to tell you, if you read your daily newspaper, you know that we have $48 million courthouses. You know we have sweetheart deals with the CSX Railroad going through Polk County. You know that we have all kinds of sweetheart deals out there along the way. That's probably why the Florida Chamber of Commerce actually likes the existing system. Okay.